Friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Topper's World. Today I'm going to share with you my own story of getting 8.5 band in IELTS reading. I appeared in academic exam nearly 10 years ago, and I was able to get 8.5 band in IELTS reading in my second attempt. In my first attempt, I could manage only 6 band, and that was a matter of shame for me, because I never expected that I would be able to get only 6 band. I was expecting 7.5 at least, but when I got my result, that was a very desperate moment for me, because all my friends were very curious to know about my result, and I didn't tell them the truth. I just told them that I got 8 band, and I didn't show my TRF to them or disclose my result, as most of the students even do in these days too. They don't want to tell their real scores. So that was a very disappointing moment for me. And then I did my self analysis. I tried to check it out what went wrong with me. Actually, I used to pretend that I'm very good in English and I could easily get 7.5 band or 8 band in IELTS reading. But the things were not so easy. I didn't practice. I only practiced for 5 or 6 reading tasks. And actually, I was a teacher in those days. I used to teach English to the 8th, 9th class students in English medium school. And I was having such a perception about myself that I would be able to crack IELTS reading or overall IELTS exam quite easily. But things were not so easy. Later on, I realized that. I realized that appearing in IELTS exam without practice, without proper making any strategies, just like jumping into the sea, and later on you made hand movements to save yourself. So same was happened with me. So later on I did deep thinking and decided try to find out that what went wrong with me. Then I saw that I just did little bit practice, and only the practice I did that was the reading tasks, which were quite easy. I didn't go for some hard readings or tough readings of Cambridge. In those days, Cambridge 5-6 books were available at for practice. I just practiced only a few tests. Later on, I found that I was not perfect in matching list of headings. My true-false were true-false, not given type questions. I was also not good in them. Sometime I was able to find the answer, sometime I was not able to. Then what I did, I tried to practice only those questions for a couple of days which were just scaring me, like list of headings. For 10 days I just practiced on list of headings. I did number of tests and I searched for list of headings only. And till I was able to get 5 out of 6 or 6 out of 7, I became confident that now I can manage with list of headings. Then I shifted to true false. Then I shifted to MCQs. MCQs were the most difficult one that I was able to manage. And one thing I realized, that if I would be able to finish my first passage in between 10 to 15 minutes, I would be able to score good. But unfortunately, I was not able to finish it even in 20 minutes. Then what I did, I just focused on the first passage for a couple of days. I practiced first passage of every test. And when my speed of reading went up and my comprehension, my understanding improved, I realized that I would be, now I am able to do 12 correct out of 13. And things improved miraculously for me after some days practice. Then I started doing full test. And when I practice for full test, I just face little bit problems, because my headings, list of heading problems, true false and MCQs, I already overcome that. And now I focused on reading passage 2, which used to be very tricky. And then reading passage 3 for a couple of days, I only practiced reading passage 3. Then I realized that now my speed of reading and my capability of understanding English improved. What I did, one special thing, that whenever I used to do the reading, I used to have a copy pen with me and write down all the difficult words. They were all academic words, and it helped me a lot to improve my vocabulary. I didn't read newspaper, I didn't go for any novels or something like that. I just focused on academic reading and collected words out of that. And the overall result was that I was able to improve my speaking. My performance in writing also went up because all the words that I collected from the reading, they were formal words, academic words, which we need to write in IELTS writing. So then after a gap of 2 months, I did hard work for 2 months, and after that I appeared in IELTS exam and I got 8.5 band in reading, and that was a moment of great joy for me. Then I shared that news with my friends, and I also told them that earlier I got 6 and now I got 8.5 band. So overall, the conclusion of this video is that you need to practice and practice hard. You shouldn't simply practice on easy reading tasks. Easy reading tasks will help you to get the score, but that is not the actual picture of your performance. Actual picture is that you have to practice hard reading tests. In exam, you are not going to get very easy reading. The easy reading you will get in the first passage, but second and third passage, they are quite lengthy and quite hard. So practice a lot. The only formula of getting a good man in IELTS reading is practice, practice, and practice. Practice till you are confident. Thank you very much for watching this video.